This is Jude's favorite place.
Chris Fisher has lived on this 200-acre wooded rural property for nearly 40 years. He thinks his grandson's survival is unbelievable.
It's just amazing he survived. I don't even know if I would have lived for that long.
On Sunday, 3-year-old Jude Layton went missing here. Police and volunteer crews combed woods and water day and night. At times, temperatures were below freezing.
It's a very treacherous area if you wander off. You know, it's quite easy to get lost. Even I have been turned around on the property myself.
From Sunday all the way to Wednesday, this clearing that's empty now was full with people, with vehicles. Fisher says two helicopters landed here until the best moment on Wednesday, when through that clearing, officers brought Jude home on an ATV.
Woo! That's the best day I've had in the OPP in 25 years.
It was Constable Scott McName's birthday when he got the call to help. He searched for 3 days.
It was rocky, it was steep. I'll be honest, I did not think that a 3-year-old, almost 4-year-old, would be able to get that far back there.
Then, less than a kilometer from the family compound, McName spotted something blue. Another officer ran up ahead.
He said, "He's here." He was lying down on his stomach, and then Jude, the little boy, raised his head and opened his eyes, and he said, "And he's alive."
McName says Jude was wet but warm. He thinks his wool sweater may have saved him. He asked for some water.
He's a tough little guy, for sure.
The last year has been just horrendous for everybody, and this is something that should be uplifting to everybody across the country.
Jude is in hospital with his parents still being checked out. The family is so grateful for everyone's support and for an unbelievably happy outcome at a time when everyone can use an extra smile. Abigail Beeman, Global News, South Frontenac, Ontario.